Hey guys, so we reached 1 million subscribers. Okay, seriously though, when I say we, I mean that because this does not feel like I've done it on my own. I don't feel like I reached a million. I honest to God just feel so thankful. The word thankful does not even mean anything because it's like there needs to be another word invented to describe the way I'm feeling at this moment. Never in my wildest dreams did I ever think that anything like this would happen to me. Just me, like I was nobody. I mean, like I'm not trying to put myself down, but like let's get real. Like I was a makeup artist at MAC Cosmetics and I loved doing makeup. And I started doing YouTube videos 2 years ago in a very dark time of my life on a camera that claimed to be HD that was $45. And 2 years later, 1 million people have subscribed to my channel and I'm blown away. And I know like so many people say this and you're just like, yeah. But honestly, like dreams do come true. I'm not Britney Spears or Christina Aguilera, but this was my dream to be a makeup artist that can inspire people and encourage people and teach them makeup artistry and make them feel beautiful inside and out because makeup is just like a universal language. And every time a girl even is like, oh yeah, I don't really like makeup, when they put it on, they feel this inner confidence and they feel empowered and they just feel like, yes, I can take on the world. And I love the power behind makeup. And that's why I started this channel. And I never in my wildest dreams thought that it would come to this. And it is all because of you guys and your love and your support. And I am so thankful. Like, I'm not gonna cry again. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your support. Thank you for everything. Just thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you times a million. Literally, thank you. So 1 million cyber hugs. I love you guys so much. Thank you. You really just feel like such good friends to me and family. And I love you. I love you and I'm grateful for you. And I appreciate you and you matter to me. So thank you so much. Okay, let's get into the video. Okay, so today's video is going to be my top / favorite highlighters. I don't really know what I'm calling this yet, obviously. All I do know is that I did do a blush video about a month and a half ago, and a lot of you guys were asking if I could do like my favorite highlighters, my favorite eyeshadows, my favorite MAC shadows, Makeup Geek shadows, lipsticks, lip glosses. You get the gist. Anyways, so I am like highlighter obsessed. I love a good highlight, so I thought I would start off with highlighters. If you guys want me to continue doing videos like this of like my favorite or top products of a certain category, give this video a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below letting me know what it is that you would like to see exactly, because I can totally do that for you. So today I'm going to be doing highlighters, obviously, and I'm going to be mentioning products I have used not only on myself but on clients as well. So all different skin tones, all different textures, all different races, all different ages, and I'll let you know like which ones I love personally for my skin tone and things around my skin tone and lighter and darker. So kind of like a range of it all. Does that make sense? Okay, let's move on. I'm only gonna talk about highlighters that you can currently purchase, because when I was picking out highlighters, there were probably like 17 that I was like, this is my holy grail. No, this is my holy grail. And as I was doing that, I was like, oh, they're all limited edition. Thanks, MAC. So the first products I'm going to start off with are just, obviously, they need to be spoken about. I'm just gonna get them out of the way right now, because if you watch my channel, you know this is coming. It is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in the shade Opal. This is like hands down right now my top favorite highlighter of life. It is so absolutely beautiful. I cannot deal with it. This is ideal for someone with my skin tone and darker. If you're super, super fair, you're probably gonna wanna go with the next one that I'm about to show you. This is an amazing dupe for MAC Whisper of Guilt, which was an Extreme Dimension Skin Finish or something like that. I don't know, I don't work for them anymore. I don't have to know. Whisper of Guilt is a very popular highlighter in the makeup world, and this is a beautiful dupe. It's absolutely gorgeous. If you are lighter, I would go with the shade Moonstone. This is the exact same product as the one before. It's just a lighter, more vanilla base. This is such a beautiful neutral highlighter. If you don't really want to look like bronzy or play up that glow like you would with Opal, Moonstone is going to be your best friend. It is just absolutely beautiful. I love this so much. Again, so creamy. It's one of the creamiest highlighters I've ever worked with. I just love these. This is the Laura Mercier Matte Radiance Baked Powder in Highlight 01. It's not matte. I don't know why it says that, but it's just not. This highlight is absolutely gorgeous. I'm probably gonna say that about every single highlighter just because these are my absolute favorites and I just love them. But this one in particular is just so beautiful because it is so universal. Someone who is extremely fair to someone who is pretty dark, who has a nice tan, can wear this highlighter. It is not too gold, it is not too bronze, and it is not too white. What I love about this is that it's not a crazy, crazy, crazy overpigmented highlighter. If you wanna make this like bing you really can get this intense, but just initially going in with the brush and dusting it on the cheekbones, it's not gonna be overwhelming or overpowering. So if you like a really light, natural looking highlight, this is gonna be your best friend. This is from Victoria's Secret, and this is called the Illuminating Face Powder in the shade Fixation. This is probably so random for those of you who watch my videos all the time, because I've never mentioned this on camera, but I've owned it for over a year, and more than using it on myself, I've used this on clients. My friend was wearing it one time, and I literally was like, yes, and on my break, walked to Victoria's Secret and bought this because it's just so beautiful. It reminds me a lot of the Laura Mercier highlighter. The difference is this one has a little bit more pink in it and a little bit more white, but it's very similar with the way that it applies. I love this highlighter. My friend who wears this is about one shade lighter than me in skin tone, but she's very yellow, and this just looks beautiful on her. It's not too pink and it's not too white. It's a mixture of both, and it is just absolutely beautiful. It looks so angelic on the cheekbones. It's just, it's gorgeous. It's a great little highlight. I love that it's small, easy to throw in your purse, ready to go. This is a Smashbox Soft Lights in the shade Shimmer. It has like a twist cap that comes off like a lot of Smashbox products. This is a very different highlighter for me because this is mainly a pink, dusty, rosy undertone, but yet it still works as a highlight. So my favorite way to wear this highlighter is actually over top of my blush, sweeping upward towards the cheekbone. You can totally wear this as just a highlighter right here on the top of the cheek. I just love wearing it over blush because I think that it really makes the whole cheek area pop. This is just so pretty. It's different. It's not like the others since it does have that pink rose undertone in it, especially on a girl with a tan. If you don't wanna play up like that bronze yellowy highlight, instead you wanna go with like a pinky glow, this is just absolutely beautiful. Mary Luminizer by The Balm. I have mentioned this ever since I think I started my YouTube channel pretty much. This is one of the best highlighters in the world. This is like the third one now that I've had that it just falls out. I have to super glue them in constantly, which is kind of funny, not a big deal. I've gone through so many of these because when I freelanced, this was pretty much my go-to highlighter that I just slapped on everybody because it's so easy. And if you are a freelance makeup artist, this is a great highlighter to own because you can literally use the tiniest amount and highlight pretty much the entire face because it is so crazy pigmented. There's honestly not much to say about this highlighter other than it's absolutely amazing. If you are into a highlight, this is like the first one I would recommend to you. It is so universal. It is just that perfect vanilla shade. It is pigmented as can be. Like, there's nothing more pigmented than this highlighter right here. It's gorgeous. If you like an intense highlight, you will get it. If you like a really soft, more natural highlight, just go very, very light-handed with your brush. This is just absolutely beautiful and one of my all-time favorites. The next highlight is called Global Glow. This is by MAC Cosmetics. They just got done revamping their packaging for their mineralized skin finishes, and I love it. I think it's so much better, and it's very sleek. The great thing that I love about MAC's mineralized skin finishes is this is not the only way it can be worn, which most products can be worn in many different ways. Let's get real, it's makeup. With this product, you can get it wet, you can use it as an eyeshadow, you can make it more metallic, you can get your blush brush wet and dust it on your cheekbones with your wet brush. I know that sounds crazy, and it'll give you like the most beautiful metallic, almost like your cheeks are wet. It is amazing. If you are going to do the whole wet thing, make sure that you use either like Max Fix Plus or some sort of hydrating mist or facial spray or even eye drops, because water sometimes can break these products up and not make it apply with as much pigment. It'll kind of just off your face. So especially something with glycerin, which is why I recommend MAC Fix Plus, is ideal to apply these wet. If you use MAC Fix Plus and then go in with this on your brush as an eyeshadow, amazing. Global Glow has like a gold river running through it along with like a bronzy beigey base. So it's not too much of anything. It's not too much bronze, too much gold. It's just perfect. This is only going to be a highlight on the cheekbones for someone who's much darker than me. This is MAC Soft and Gentle. This is the old packaging before they just got done revamping it. This is an oldie but a goodie for me. This is a more pinky, neutral highlight with gold flecks in it. The gold flecks in it are not glitter, they're not chunky, but there are gold flecks. I can tend to be someone who only likes a highlight that is just nothing but just smooth and creamy, and I don't want any flecks or any glitter in it. I just want it to be so airbrushed and just like perfect. Is that too much to ask? Perfect? This one does have a little bit of flex in it, but it's done in a very beautiful way. And it's really nice because it makes it much more universal since it's like a pink base, but yet it has gold in it. It makes it very neutral for a lot of skin tones to use. It is absolutely beautiful. This is Stila's All Over, what is this? All Over Shimmer Duo in the shade Kitten. First of all, the kitten eyeshadow, don't even get me started. I have used that a million times to highlight, and that is amazing. I should have included that, but I didn't, sorry. This is such a fun product because first of all, it's small, it's compact, it can go anywhere with you. And on one side, you have a pink highlight, and on another side, you have a bronzy highlight. I personally love mixing them together because I think it's just absolutely beautiful, but I love that it's so tiny and you get two highlighters in one. I definitely went through a phase where I was obsessed with this pink highlight. I was wearing it constantly for like a month or two straight, but they're gorgeous. And I love it because you can use this one when you're fair and use this one in the summer. They're both equally beautiful. They're very pigmented. I love them. I love how cute and tiny this is. I think it's a great idea. This is totally random, but I'm going to mention an eyeshadow. This is Nylon by MAC. I have to mention this because even though it's a shadow, it is just such a beautiful highlight. And if you want something itty-bitty that can go everywhere with you and you can put in a little Z palette, this is your guy. Nylon is just so beautiful. It is intense. So just watch out. Like one little swipe and it's like boom in your face. It will light you up like a disco ball. But when I was working at MAC, I would use this on girls who liked an intense highlight. I would also use this on girls who were very fair. And I would also use this on girls who have a lot of yellow and olive in their skin tone. So very olive complexions, just a lot of yellow. A lot of people have very yellow skin and things can be kind of difficult for them because foundations and highlighters and blushes, I have something in my eye, can all be very pink and just not work. So this is just a beautiful highlight. If you have yellow in your skin, it's gorgeous. Again, it's intense. So make sure that when you go in with it, you are just like literally like, is all you need. Just barely touch it and that's all you need. This is beautiful as a brow highlight, inner corner highlight, cupid bow highlight, cheek highlight. It's just like all around a perfect highlight and it is Nylon Eyeshadow by MAC. This is my favorite drugstore highlighter. To me personally, it's very hard to find a good highlighter at the drugstore. I've tried tons of them and for some reason they always seem to be very chalky, very dusty, and you'll get tons of it on your hands and like your brush and try to apply it and it just kind of falls and it's very sad. So this is my favorite. It doesn't do that. This is by the brand Hard Candy. It is called Tiki. It is referred to as a baked bronzer. It's not a bronzer, it's a highlight. It's absolutely beautiful. It's predominantly a gold beigey tone in it. This is so pretty though, it really is. It's not like the best highlighter in the world, but if you're a girl on a budget and you're trying to find something at the drugstore, this is going to be your best friend. It is so pretty. I went through a phase with this as well where I was using it constantly. But honestly, the ingredients in it just, they can tend to irritate my skin, which is why I don't grab this as often as I would like to because it is so pretty. But I'm an ingredient girl. I have an issue with ingredients. I just have the most sensitive skin in the world and I have to be careful. This highlighter is from the drugstore as well. This is by Physicians Formula and it is the Powder Palette Mineral Glow Pearls in the shade Beige Pearl. I've heard some negative things about this product and I have to just be honest, for me, I have not had like any issues like I've seen some other reviews say. Maybe I just got like a randomly good product, I don't know. The only thing about this product is that it is very sheer. You really have to pack it on. It's not gonna be really intense. It's not gonna give you a very bing highlight on the cheekbone. It's gonna be a very sheer wash of highlight, which can be ideal for some people. So if you're someone who just wants a little bit of a highlight, this is ideal for you. It's a very neutralized highlight. It's not too light, it's not too dark. So it's going to work on a wide range of skin tones. We are almost at the finish line, people. This is NARS Albatross. I have not talked about this in so long, but I used to be obsessed with this highlighter. This is a very yellow gold based highlighter. It is very pretty. It almost looks green, honestly, when you're looking at it like this. It is so pretty on someone who has a bit of a tan, especially if you are yellow based in skin. Oh my gosh, it is so, so pretty. But this is very yellowy. This is not neutral, this is not bronze, this is a yellow highlight. So just be aware of that. It is beautiful, beautiful. I used to absolutely love it when I had a little bit more color in my skin, but it is yellow, just know, but it's absolutely gorgeous. Last but not least is a pigment from MAC. This is called Melon. I can't, okay, there's like fuzzies everywhere in the air. I can't even tell you how obsessed I was with this pigment. I literally use this as my highlight on my cheekbones every single day for probably a year. And what's crazy is it literally looks untouched. It is ideal for summertime, ideal with somebody who has a little bit of a tan, and mixing this in with your foundation in the summer is so beautiful. Ow. But this is not going to work on somebody who's extremely fair as a cheekbone highlight. Again, you can use anything over your blush. Any of these, if you purchase a highlight and you're like, this is too dark, like it looks pink on my cheekbone, it looks too brown on my cheekbone, it looks dusty on my cheekbone, you put that baby over a blush and it's gonna work. It's just going to be a highlight a little bit lower on the cheeks, which kind of makes you look like you have a natural glow as opposed to highlighting high up on the cheek. Because there is definitely a difference between highlighting on the top of the cheekbone and then making a glow on the cheeks. Does that make sense? You guys are probably like, what? That completes my favorite highlighters, well, at least my favorite powder highlighters, because I do have liquid highlighters and luminizers as well, but we just weren't gonna get into that today. It's a little much. So yes, I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. Again, if you want to see more of these with different products and different categories, give this video a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments exactly what you'd like to see, and I will totally start a series for you. So I hope that you guys enjoy this video. Again, thank you so much for 1 million subscribers. I love you, and I'll see you soon. Bye. It'll be flat in 2 seconds. Recently, I'm like, my babies. I feel like confetti should be like falling down right now. Okay, let's just stop. But when I actually saw like my subscribers hit that 1 million mark, I was like, we are the champions. Bum, 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 bum. This is why I don't wear my hair down. It a little bit. It is, oh, amazeballs.